Dear students, welcome to Ishikshana program. I am Dr. V. Ramchandramurthy, Professor of Mathematics, RR Institute of Technology, Bangalore. In today's class also, I will be considering problems on equations solvable for y. Now let me consider this problem. Number 3, obtain general and a singular solution of x into p square minus 2yp plus x equal to 0 by solving for y. So, as the solution, part of the solution, first we shall solve the equation for y. So, let me write down the given equation first. The given differential equation, x into p square minus 2y into p plus x equal to 0. So let me call this as equation number 1. So let me solve this for p. If I solve this for p, solve for y. So I can conveniently write this as 2 into yp is equal to x into p square plus x. So therefore, y is x into p square plus x divided by 2 into p. Okay. Now let me differentiate this with respect to y. X. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. So then dy by dx is equal to, so it is a quotient rule we have to apply here, 2 into p denominator square, 2 into p whole square, the numerator 2 into p into, this is the product of x and p. So this is p square into 1 plus x into 2p dp by dx, that is 2x into p 2p into dp by dx plus 1 minus xp square plus x into differentiation of 2p with respect to x. So this is 2 into dp by dx. 2p, 2 into p dp by dx. Now let me simplify this first. So this is equal to, so this what dy by dx is p, so write p for this one. So multiply, so this is 2 into p cube plus 4 x into p square, 4 x into p square into dp by dx plus 2p, then minus 2 x into p square, dp by dx, minus 2x dp by dx, 2x into dp by dx. So divided by 4p square. So divided by 4 into p square. Now let me cross multiply. 4 into p square into p is 4p cube. 4 into p cube. So this is equal to 2p cube. 2p cube. So now I can add these two, 4xp square minus 2xp square dp by dx is plus 2x into p square dp by dx, then plus 2p, This we have considered already. So minus
2 into x dp by dx. Now let me take 2 into p cube to the left hand side. So 4 into p cube minus 2p cube minus 2xp square minus 2xp square dp by dx minus 2p plus 2x dp by dx equal to 0. Now 4p cube minus 2p cube is 2 into p cube minus, I'll write minus 2p here, then minus 2x p square plus into dp by dx into dp by dx plus 2x into dp by dx equal to 0. Okay. So now let me simplify. I'll take 2p outside here. 2 into p. So this can be written as p square minus 1. And similarly, if I take minus 2x into dp by dx into dp by dx minus 2x into dp by dx from these two. Now this is minus 2x p square, so I get p square here and this is minus 1 because plus 2x into dp by dx equal to 0. The further you can write this as 2p minus 2x into dp by dx into p square minus 1 equal to 0. Okay. Now let me consider 2p minus 2x dp by dx equal to 0 for a general solution. For general solution, or consider 2p minus 2x dp by dx equal to 0, ignoring the other possibility that is p square minus 1 equal to 0, which leads to a singular solution, which leads to a singular solution. So that means, therefore, 2p is equal to 2 into x dp by dx. dp by dx. Now, this is the first order differential equation, Now, separating the variables, which can be solved easily by separating the variables. Separating the variables. We have time. The 2 also get cancelled. dp by p is equal to dx by x. The variables are separated, so therefore its solution is integration of each side is equal to integral dx by x plus interval constant, let me take it as log c. So integral of dp by p is log p is equal to log x plus log c. So therefore you can easily find out p as c into x.
Otherwise
this is equal to log c into x, therefore p is c into x. Now substitute this in one. Substitute in one. That is the given equation x into p square, that is n x into p square minus 2 into y into p plus x equal to 0. Let me substitute in this equation. X into p square, x into c square, x square then minus 2 into y, p is c into x plus x equal to 0. So this is c square x cube minus 2 c into x into y plus x equal to 0. Now this is the required, which is the general solution, so call this as equation 2, which is the general solution general solution of the given differential equation 1. Now to find the singular solution, differentiate two partially with respect to c. So we can easily see this. This is 2c into x cube minus 2xy plus 0 is equal to 0. Solve for c. So 2 we can cancel. So c is equal to x into y by x cube, or c is equal to y divided by x square. Substitute in 2. Substitute in 2. Then c is y by x square. So c square is y square by x power 4. Y square divided by x power 4 into x cube minus 2 into c, that is y divided by x square, 2 into y by x square into x into y plus x equal to 0. So one x you can cancel here and x cube we can cancel. So this is y square divided by x minus 2 into y square divided by x plus x equal to 0. Okay, multiply throughout by x. So therefore, multiply by x throughout, then you get y square minus 2 into y square plus x square equal to
0.
Equal to 0. Or this is x square. X square minus y square
equal to 0, which is the required
singular solution of the given differential equation, which is the required singular solution,
of the given differential equation. Of the given differential equation. So let me consider our last example. After that, I'll be considering the last part of the syllabus, that is in the self-study portion, application of ODEs to LR circuits.
The last problem. Solve. Y is equal to cos P plus P sine P. By solving for y. Okay. The given equation is y is equal to cos p plus p sine p. Call this as equation number 1. Here we have to only find the general solution, not the singular solution. So let me differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to minus sine p into dp by dx plus product rule here, sine p into differentiation of p with respect to x dp by dx plus p cos p into dp by dx. So I can cancel this one, these two terms. So dy by dx is p is equal to p into cos p into dp by dx, or can cancel p also, or 1 is equal to cos p into dp by dx. This is the first order differential equation which can be solved easily, separating the variables, separating the variables. We have dx is equal to cos p dp.
Dx is equal to cos p dp.
So what the variables are separated, its solution is integration of each side integral dx is equal to cos p dp plus some constant c. So integration of dx, that is x, is equal to integration of cos p is plus sin p plus c. Or this can be written as sin p is equal to x minus c. Therefore, p is equal to sin inverse of x minus c. Sin inverse of x minus c. Now substitute this in this equation. Substitute in one. Substitute in one. Then y is equal to cos of p is sin inverse of x minus c, close the bracket, plus p sin inverse of x minus c into sin of sin inverse of x minus c. Sin of sin inverse x minus c is x minus c. So therefore, y is equal to cos of sin inverse x minus c, and this is x minus c, plus x minus c into sin inverse of x minus c.
So which is the general solution of the given equation 1?
Which is the required general solution of the given differential equation.
So with this, I'll be concluding the problems on equations solvable for y. The last topic in this self-study is the application of ODEs to LR circuits.
So let me consider this final application and also last topic of this module 3 of calculus and differential equations, which is the course for first semester BE 21 scheme, having core 21 MAT 11. Application of ODEs to LR circuits. Applications of ODEs, that is ordinary differential equations, LR circuits. The formulation of the differential equation for an electrical circuit depends on the Kirchhoff's law, or based on the Kirchhoff's law. So let me mention this. The formulation of differential equation for an electrical circuit for an electrical circuit is based on Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's law. Now let me mention the Kirchhoff's law here. Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's law says that the algebraic sum of the voltage drop across a closed circuit is equal to the resultant electromotive force in the circuit. So let me mention this. The algebraic sum, this law says that the algebraic sum of the voltage drops around any closed circuit is equal to the resultant, is equal to the resultant, is equal to the resultant electromotive force in the circuit. Electromotive force in the circuit. This is the Kirchhoff's law on voltage. Let us find what are these voltage drops. So note one, current I is rate of change of charges, that is I is equal to dq by dt. Voltage drop across resistance R is equal to R into I. Voltage drop of inductance L across resistance. Voltage drop across resistance R is equal to R into I. Voltage drop across inductance L is equal to L into di by dt. So what are these L R circuit? LR circuit. LR circuit. Consider a circuit. Consider a circuit. Circuit containing resistance R and inductance L. Inductance L in series with voltage E. That means the circuit is current I flowing in the circuit. This is the resistance R, this is the inductance L, and this is the voltage E battery. Okay. This is the LR circuit. Let I be the current flowing in the circuit. This I be the current flowing in the circuit at any time t. then by Kirchhoff's law on voltage, Kirchhoff's law, we have the voltage drop across R and L, the sum of voltage drops. We have the sum of voltage drops across resistance R and inductance L. Sum of voltage drops across R and L is equal to E. So mathematically, voltage drop across, that is voltage drop across R into I plus voltage drop across L into di by dt is equal to E. The differential equation associated with LR circuit is this. Okay. R this can be written as divided throughout by L. R by L into I plus plus di by dt is equal to E by N. Or writing in order, R di by dt plus R by L into I is equal to E by L. Call this as equation number one. Now this is a Leibniz linear equation in I, where P is R by L and Q is E by L. This is a linear equation, Leibniz linear equation, which is a Leibniz linear equation in I, and its solution is I into integrating factor is equal to integral Q into integrating factor dt plus some constant C. So here P is R by L, Q is E by L. P is R by L, Q is E by L. Now let me find out the integrating factor. Integrating factor is e power integral p dt, which is equal to e power integral r divided by l dt, or this is e power rt by l. E power rt by l. Now substitute in to call this as equation 2. Substitute in equation 2. So I into e power rt by L, rt by L is equal to integral Q, Q is E by L into E power RT by L DT plus some constant C. So further, this is equal to E by L is constant, so I can write outside. Integration of E power RT by L, it is like E power integration of E power AT, E power AT by A. So integration of E power RT by L is E power RT by L, RT by L divided by RT by L divided by R by L, R by L. So L, L we can cancel, so this is plus C. So therefore I into E power RT divided by L is equal to E by R E power RT divided by L plus C. Let me further simplify. Multiply throughout by E power minus RT by L. Then current I is equal to E by R into 1 plus C into E power minus RT divided by L. Call this as equation number 2. Now which is the current I at any time t? At any time. Okay. So now initially to start with current is 0. That means I is equal to 0.
when t is equal to 0. If initially there is no current, if initially
there is no current in the circuit, now current in the circuit initially, if there is no current in the circuit, that is I is equal to 0 where t is equal to 0 from 3 I is 0 when t is 0 is equal to e divided by r, e by r plus c, e by r plus c. Therefore, c is minus e by r. Substitute in 3 the value of c. Substitute in 3 that current I is equal to e by r plus c is minus e by r, so minus e by r. Minus e by r into e power minus rt by l. R I is e by r into 1 minus e power minus rt by l. All this as equation number 4. Now, as t increases, this becomes 0 and I achieves its maximum value e by r. That means when t tends to infinity, t tends to infinity. So this shows that I increases and attains its maximum value. This shows that I increases and attains its maximum value e by r with the increase in time. So this shows that this shows that I increases with time. I increases with time t and attains its maximum value e by r.
Okay. So with this, let me consider classical examples. When a switch
when a switch is closed, in a circuit, containing a battery a resistor and an inductance L. The circuit, the current I, builds up at a rate given by R into I plus L di by dt is equal to E. Find I. As a function of t, further, how long will it be? Before the current has reached, one half its final value, if E is equal to 6 volts, are 100 ohms and L 0.1 henry, 0.12 henry. So this is a problem associated with LR circuit, a closed circuit having resistance R is equal to 100 ohms, inductance L is equal to 0.1 henry, and battery of 6 volts. Okay. The differential equation associated with is given the problem itself, that is the algebraic sum of the voltage drops across the resistance and inductance L is equal to the resultant electromotive force, that is E. The solution part, Let I be the current. Let I be the current. Be the current flowing in the circuit. The circuit at any time t, then by Kirchhoff's law, R into I plus L into di by dt is equal to E. R, this can be written as dividing by L throughout di by dt plus R by L into I is equal to E by L. All this is equation number 1. Now let me substitute, let me substitute the values of R, L and E. Therefore, di by dt plus R is 100 divided by L 0.1 I is equal to E. E is 6 divided by L. L is 0.1. R, this can be written as di by dt 100 by 0.1 is 1000 into I, 6 by 0.1 is 60. So call this as 1. So this is nothing but the Leibniz linear equation in I, which is a Leibniz linear equation in I. Leibniz linear equation in I. Equation in I. At its solution and its solution is I into integrating factor is equal to Q into integrating factor dt plus C. Okay. So here P is 1000, Q is 60. Q is 60. So therefore, we call this as 2. Let me find out integrating factor IF is e power integral p dt, that is e power integral 1000 into t dt is equal to e power 1000 is constant, integration of dt is t. Now substitute into a 2. Substitute into I into e power 1000 t is equal to Q. Q is 60 e power 1000 t dt plus c. Okay. So this is I e power 1000 t is 60 is constant. Integration of e power 1000 t is 1000 t e power 1000 t divided by 1000 plus c. So this is 350. So therefore, I e power 1000 t is equal to 3 divided by 50 e power 1000 t plus c.
Now multiply
by e power minus 1000 t then I is equal to 3 divided by 50 into 1 plus c e power minus 1000 t.
Initially, if there is no current flowing in the circuit, since I is equal to 0 when t is equal to 0, since I is 0 when t is 0, that is initially there is no current, then 0 is equal to 3 divided by 50 plus c, therefore c is minus 3 divided by 50. Now substitute in this equation 3. Substitute in 3. So I is equal to 3 by 50 minus 3 by 50 e power minus 1000 t. So therefore, I is equal to 3 divided by 50 into 1 minus e power minus 1000 t. Remember, in our question, so this is the current at any time t. The next question is, how long will it be before the current has reached one of its final value? One of its final value is E by R. One of its final value, I, is E by R divided by 2.
When I is one of its final value is E by R. So what is E? E is 6, R is 100, so this is 3 by 100.
Okay.
So 3 divided by 100 is equal to 3 divided by 50 into 1 minus e power 1000.
So our question is, how long will it be? That means we have to find time. We have to find time when I has reached one of its final value.
One of, that is 1 by 2, into its final value is E by R. So you can easily find out. This is, so 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is equal to 1 minus e power minus 1000 t.
Okay.
R e power minus 1000 t is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2. So if you take log on both sides, log e power minus 1000 t is log of 1 by 2, which is equal to log of 1 minus log of 2. So, a log of 1 is 0. So, therefore, log e power minus 1000 t is minus log 2, because log of 1 is 0. Log of 1 is 0. So therefore, minus 1000 t is equal to log 2. Minus log 2. Therefore, t is equal to log 2 divided by 1000. So this is, if you calculate, you get 0.006931 seconds. Another problem, second problem, a resistance of 100 ohms an inductance of 0.5 Henry are connected in series with a battery of 20 volts. Find the current in the circuit at t is equal to 0.5 seconds. If I is equal to 0 at t is equal to 0, that is initiating 0, there is no current. Solution. Let I be the current flowing in the LR series circuit at any time t, so this is the circuit. You have a resistance, then you have the inductance L, then you have a battery of 20 volts, and the current I flowing here. This is the resistance R, this is the inductance L, and this is your battery of 20 volts. Okay. So then the Kirchhoff law says some of the algebraic sum of the voltage drops across resistance and inductance L is equal to E. So voltage drop across R is R into I. Voltage drop across L into di by dt is equal to I.
Okay.
R dividing throughout by L, we get R by L plus into I di by dt is equal to E by L. R this can be written as di by dt plus R by L. R is 100, R is 100, okay, R by L is equal to E by L. So here, R is given to be 100 ohms, L is 0.5 Henry, then E is 20 volts. Now let me substitute here. So therefore, we have di by dt plus R by L, 100 divided by 0.5 R by L, I is equal to E 20 by 0.5. 0.5 is 1 by 2. So therefore, you can write this as di by dt. So this is 200 into I is equal to 40. All these are
1.
So one is a Laplace linear equation. One is a Laplace linear equation in I,
and its a solution,
and its
solution,
and its solution is I into integrating factor is equal to integral Q into integrating factor dt plus some integral constant C.
Okay.
So where P and Q here, P is 200 and Q is 60, so therefore my integrating factor is e power integral P dt, this is e power integral 200 dt is e power 200 t. Okay. Now, substitute in 2. We call this as equation 2. Substitute into I into e power 200 t is equal to integral Q is 60, Q is 40 into e power 250 dt plus c. So this is equal to 40 into e power 200 t divided by 200 plus c. Integration of e power 200 t is this. Further, this is e power 200 t into I is equal to e power 200 t divided by 5 plus c. So multiply by e power minus 200 t throughout, then I is equal to 1 by 5 plus c into e power minus 200 t. So initially, since I is equal to 0 when t is equal to 0, initially there is no current, therefore I is equal to 0 when t is equal to 0, then 0 is equal to 0 is equal to 1 by 5 plus c. When t is 0, c, therefore c is minus 1 divided by 5. C is 1 divided by 5. That's the shift now. So therefore I is equal to 1 divided by 5 minus 1 divided by 5 e power minus 200 t. Substitute for c. C is minus 1 by 5. So I is 1 divided by 5 into 1 minus e power minus 200 t. So as per our question, we need to find the current at t is equal to 0.5 seconds. At t is equal to 0.5 seconds. That means, so this is at any point, at any time t, when t is 0.5 seconds, your I is 1 by 5 into 1 minus e power minus 200 into 1 by 2, that is 0.5. If you carefully simplify this, find the value using calculator, you get I is equal to 0.2 amperes. At the time t is equal to 0.5, the current in the circuit is 0.2 amperes. This completes your module 3 of first semester mathematics course titled Calculus and Differential Equations, having code 21 MAT 11. Throughout my sessions, classes, I have considered problems taken from the bold question papers in addition to solving a good number of classical important questions. In case if you have any doubt, you can contact me. I will write my email ID. Please make a note of that and try to contact me through mail. Post your questions, raise your doubts. I will be always at your service. I will be very happy to answer all your questions. Once again, I thank the authorities of VTU for giving me this opportunity to connect with you all through this very, very important, prestigious eShikshana Program 6.
I wish you all the best for your examination. Thank you. And once again, I am Dr. V. Ramachandramurthy, Professor of Mathematics, RR Institute of Technology, Bangalore. So make a note of my mail ID and post your questions and raise your doubts. You can reach out to me with this mail ID. I'll be very, very happy to interact with you. Thank you.